would you cook something if you didn't have electricity or fire?
Well, what if I told you you could use basic materials to harness the power of the sun with a pizza box?
I partnered with Columbia, who just so happen to be experts in harnessing the power of light, to teach you how to make a solar oven. All you need to make your solar oven is a pizza box, black paper and tape, some aluminum foil, a glass bowl, and finally something to cook. We will be making s'mores. Our solar oven is really a light converter. We will be doing three things to convert shorter wavelength light into longer wavelength light. Huh? What does that mean? Well, visible light is the kind that we see with our eyes. Think Roy G. Biv, the rainbow. This is the type of light that's in the middle of the electromagnetic spectrum. This is the shorter wavelength light that we'll be capturing and converting. When you have light waves that are slightly longer than visible light, it becomes something else, infrared light. This is the invisible light that is emitted when something is hot. In fact, your own body gives off infrared light, but you can only see it with one of those fancy heat sensing cameras. This is where Columbia's OmniHeat Infinity technology comes into play. It takes advantage of your own body heat. These little gold dots reflect that infrared light, that body heat, back onto your body, keeping you warm. The genius is in its simplicity. It's very much a work smarter, not harder type of technology. You don't need electricity, you don't need batteries. You just need to trap that invisible light you're already emitting. We're going to be using this light harnessing technology as inspiration to get our solar oven as hot as possible. Speaking of which, our black paper is already getting pretty hot, so let's go ahead and lay that on the bottom of our pizza box and tape it down. We're using black paper here because black absorbs visible light and then converts it into heat or infrared light. We're not using white paper here because white would reflect that light away, acting more like a mirror. This is why we wear lighter colors on a hot day to keep us cool. The second thing we're going to do is put our tin foil on the top part of our pizza box. This is going to act like a mirror, reflecting as much of that visible light as possible onto our black paper into our solar oven. Now tape it at an angle so it's reflecting light into the solar oven, just like that. And finally, we are going to put a glass bowl over our s'mores or whatever you choose to cook. This is going to create a greenhouse effect that traps the light. Here's what's going to happen. Shorter wavelength light from the sun will come into our glass bowl, but then it is heated up by the black paper and converted into longer wavelength light, into infrared light. But here's the cool part. Are you ready for this? Infrared light cannot go through glass because glass acts like a mirror to longer wavelength light. So here's what we've done. We have trapped that heat, that infrared light inside of our bowl, and that's going to make it hotter and hotter and hotter. Now go ahead and put your chocolate in, put your bowl on top, and point your solar oven towards the sun. We have our control here so that we can compare. Now, depending on how hot your day is, this will take between 2 minutes to like 10 minutes. But after that, your chocolate should be nice and melty. Oh my gosh, this says, look at this, 112. That's crazy. Oh wow, that's like a 25, 30 almost degree difference. Now for the highly scientific smoosh test. Okay, you ready? 3, 2, 1. Look at that smush. Oh no, oh my gosh, wow, okay. That is very melty. Thank you, solar oven. Good job, solar oven. Now we'll compare the smushability to our control. It smushes, but it doesn't melt. So, solar oven wins this round. This is the power of harnessing light. Thank you to Columbia for sponsoring this video. Be sure to use OmniHeat Infinity technology to keep you warm and use a solar oven to get things hot. Whoa!